Honestly, I probably did. Here it is.
Are you serious?
Oh my god. All right.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Kaley Gray, and I have my friend Karena here
with me.
And she's also my hairstylist, and so you probably saw by the title today that she is gonna be doing some fun hairstyles for us because, you know, it is coming to the end of the year, beginning of the new year, so we are gonna be having, you know, maybe some events, even if it's just to your living room. Everybody, you know, it's fun to get dressed up and do your hair, and so.
Even in quarantine.
Yes, and so she always makes me look super fresh with my blonde hair, so she is gonna teach us some of her tricks, and so, but before we start, be sure, if you have not subscribed to this channel, to hit that red button below.
Subscribe now.
And follow me on Facebook and Instagram. And I'm gonna also link her stuff, and so make sure that you follow her. Even if you're not in the Tulsa area, you still need to follow her because she's amazing. And if you are here, you need to get your hair done by her because she's amazing. So,
well, thank you.
What are we gonna start with today?
Okay, so first, a lot of my clients have asked questions about how to curl their hair, so ask no more. I'm gonna use the T3 1.25 inch barrel. I'm not using the wand. So first you'll need two clips. I call them alligator clips. They look like this. And you're gonna brush out the hair first. Kaley, where do you wanna part it today? You're gonna do a side part or back?
Yeah, side part.
Where it's at? Okay.
Yeah, I think where it's at.
So we're just gonna go ahead and brush out her hair.
Should I turn?
No, you're good.
Okay.
You are good. So I always like to divide the hair up in three sections. Like if you think of like a three-story house or something, you wanna go one, two, three. So you're gonna go like this. Kaley, do you have a hard time curling your hair? Are you a pro?
I have recently learned how to do it my own. I can do the wand. That's the only way I can curl my hair recently. So.
Some people have to wear a glove when they do the wand.
So I do not have to use the glove.
I'm a pro now. Okay, so once you have your first row, you're just gonna take a section that's about an inch and a half wide, like this. And I always leave out the ends about half an inch out. And we're gonna curl away from the face. Yeah, a lot of people struggle with curling because they always get like a dent in their hair.
Yeah.
So if you get a dent, then you know you're doing it wrong. Usually, sometimes I alternate the curls, but for this look, I'm gonna do them all away from the face to create like a beachy wave. Hairspray is your best friend too. Don't forget the hairspray.
All about the hairspray.
That's right. So we're just gonna do this. You don't wanna take too small of a section, because we're not trying to look like Shirley Temple over here.
Please don't.
No.
I do like Shirley Temple though. Those are good movies.
She's a cutie, but her hair's not, so we're not gonna do that today.
My mom used to do that like with the pink rollers.
Really?
Do you ever sleep in those at night?
Yes.
Yeah.
I used to use, I remember I had these snap roller things. They were like, I don't know, made out of fabric or something. My mom was snapping my hair.
Yeah.
But I definitely got tighter curls, not a fan.
Maybe for like a 2-year-old, but you know. A 30-year-old.
But these curls are nice. They can last you for a couple days. So if you wake up the next day, you can just go ahead and pop in a few more curls.
I've also recently been using a silk pillowcase. Best investment ever. It has kept my like curls and stuff like that for 2 or 3 days.
I was just gonna mention that. I definitely recommend the silk pillowcases too. Okay. The other thing is you never want to touch the curl when it's warm, you want to wait. If you want to tossle it, you wait till it's kind of cooled a little bit. Then, after your client's coughing up a storm, we're going to move on to the next section. We're going to go like this. Once you get to the top section, it's a lot easier because you literally just curl like three to four sections, you're done. The ones that are next to the face, you always want to do away. You never want to curl hugging your face. That's not attractive.
That is one thing I've learned.
Yes. These curls are so cute.
They are really cute.
How long do your curls usually last you?
Like, I would say at least 2 days.
Do you have to touch them up the next day or no?
It depends on like if I want them to be more of like a bigger curl or if they're just kind of like a loose wave.
Right. So if you want like a tighter wave that lasts longer, you can use like a 1-inch curling iron and that'll last even longer, but then you're stuck with the...
Yeah, I think that my first day is usually a 1-inch, so it is. I feel like I'm like...
It is pretty though. This is a happy medium, the 1.25. It's not too big, not too small, so it'll give you the perfect beach wave. But always remember to leave out about an inch to a half inch out at the ends. That's key to get the wave. Do you like to brush out your curls, or do you just use your wife?
I use
comb?
My comb.
Good girl.
I don't have it. I use my fingers.
Some people like to brush them out, but I like to use a wide tooth comb, or I just use my hands to like loosen them just a little.
I love your curls today.
Thank you. It's the T3 iron.
Your hair is my goal to someday be that length. We're getting there.
Yeah, your hair, it's getting longer.
It is.
But you also keep up with your trims too, so your hair doesn't break off. Like some of my clients, they don't like to cut their hair at all. They do it twice a year, you know who you are.
She makes me do it every other time.
That's right, I'm like, okay, I don't think we cut your hair last time. It's fine.
I know, she remembers too. I'm like, oh, do we really need to cut it?
But you usually don't tell when I take off.
No, we just, you just.
I mean, a little.
Yeah, because I am curling it, heating. So.
Yeah. So the top section, you can take a little bit bigger sections, because like I said, you only need like 3 or 4 on the top.
Man, I'm gonna have my hair done and nowhere to go. It's okay.
Oh well, at least you'll have a better idea how to do it.
Exactly. I'm so excited. I'm gonna probably like be the most viewer of this video just so I know how to do hair. I'm horrible at hair, guys. Like, I can curl my hair with a wand and that's about it. I got those, what are they called? Those rubber bands that are like that.
Oh, the telephone cord ones?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, I actually brought some of those. Do you use those?
I do, and actually they have been giving me the best like messy buns ever.
They're awesome. I like them way better than the actual rubber bands themselves because they don't like snap the hair and break it.
Yeah.
It's healthier on your hair and it doesn't leave a crease in your hair.
And I have thin hair, so I feel like it makes my hair look fuller too.
When you do the bun up style?
Uh-huh. But I'm not an expert, so don't take my advice.
It does work better, she's right. So take her advice on that.
And can I just say, we did not call each other. We both just wore black because we're blonde.
Yeah.
And blondes look good in black.
That's right. There we go, thank you. Now we're gonna curl this, also away from the face. Hold it there for a couple seconds. So, try not to touch the hair too much because it's still warm. Let it cool. As soon as it cools, within a few seconds, you'll take your hairspray. I'm using Karena sauce. Spray it real good. So, I'm gonna take a wide tooth comb like this, And I'm just going to go along the ends of the hair and then just comb it out just a little, not too much. You only want to do one pass. Go. And that's how you curl your hair.
Okay, so what's next? We've got my hair curled.
So now you just need different clips. I have some sparkly ones, pearl, and this awesome cheetah one. So I'm gonna show you a few different ways how you can style the hair with a pretty little clip. So first, there was a girl on TV I saw and I thought this was so cute. She took, actually it looked just like this, and she literally took it and just pinned it back like that. Kaylee, turn your head towards the mirror. So then you just have a simple clip like that. Okay, the next look would be more of a twisted look. I'm gonna take my sparkly one and I'm just gonna leave out a few pieces around her face. I'm gonna take a section about this big and I'm gonna have you tilt your head towards me just a little. And I'm just gonna twist these like this. And as you're twisting, you wanna grab a little more hair underneath and add it to that hair. So this kind of gives it more of a bohemian vibe to it. And then once you have that, you're gonna go ahead and take your clip and place it right here where you stopped the little twist. To make it look more full, something I like to do is to separate it just a little. So Kaylee can kind of face the mirror. There's that look.
Oh, that's
so cute. Super pretty. It dresses up any hairstyle, and it's one of my favorites to do.
And that didn't take too long. And I feel like that's something I could do.
And that's the other thing. This is what this tutorial is about. Basically, it's stuff that you can do at home, and you don't have to go to your stylist to do a simple clip in your hair. Another one that I like to do is, say if you have a formal event to like a wedding or something, you can take your hair and literally pull it straight back and then just kind of twist it just a little and take your clip. I'm gonna use this pearl one and clip it down just like that. So there's that look. So there's a bunch of different looks you can do just by using the clips. Pretty interesting.
Oh, that one's so cute.
Which one's your favorite so far?
Man, I kind of like this
one. Isn't that cute? I actually wore this one for my friend's wedding. A girl at our salon, she actually styled my hair and did this, and I love it.
It looks great. I like it, and I feel like I'll watch the video and I'll learn how to do it because I wasn't paying attention.
And it dresses up any style. Like if you have like an outfit that's just like plain, like all black with silver wearing, you just take it, pin it back, and it looks super fancy and elegant.
It does. Where do you get like clips like this?
So I actually found these at TJ Maxx. I found some at Marshall's, Amazon.
Yeah.
Sweet. And then where did you find this cute cheetah one?
That one I found at One Love Babe, this like online boutique.
So cute. Yeah, I love that.
I've had that for like probably a year and I haven't like figured out how to like put it in my hair. I know that sounds like crazy that I can't figure it out, but that's why I was super excited about this for you to show me how to do it.
It's super simple. And then when you're doing the twist, I always recommend doing it on the side where you have more hair. So in this case, she has more hair on this side because she parts her hair over here. So you definitely want to do the twisty on this side. You can always take as little or as much hair that you want. I always think less is better because if you do too much hair, then you're left with not enough down here.
Mm. I don't have a lot of hair.
Hey, it's us blondes, right?
I know.
We don't breakage.
Yes, but I'm a blonde.
See, and there's a cute little twisty also with the little cheetah clip.
Oh, so, yeah, so fun.
That's all the looks you can do with some cute clips. For the next style, we're gonna be doing a cute little bun on the top of her head. Kaylee, what do you like to call this one?
It's the only one I
don't call it the man bun. Whatever.
No, it's not the man bun.
It's the she bun.
The she bun.
That's what we're doing.
She did this one for my birthday and I absolutely loved it.
You wore it for like a couple days,
I did.
That tells you that she really liked it.
I did. I kept
it. Okay,
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna leave out some hair on her face, the usual, because no one likes their hair to be slicked straight back, okay? So what we're gonna do is take some hair, about this much. And you are just going to take it and get a little bit more. How much hair are you wanting to leave out in the front?
Yeah.
Is that good?
Yeah, I like that.
Okay. Okay.
A little less. So you can kind of gauge how much hair you want to leave out of the bun just by looking at it in the mirror. According to what looks good. Do you think that's enough hair?
I like it. I think that's perfect.
Okay.
Yeah.
You don't want too much and you don't want too little. Take some out of here. You got some tangles. There we go. Maybe put your head back with this just a little. Perfect. So what I'm gonna do is just take the hair and go like this, and you want to have one of these little mini rubber bands. You can get them anywhere. But they're gonna be your best friend for this tutorial. So you're gonna wrap it around twice. Then you're gonna take this weave out, wrap it around, and you are gonna start bobby pinning these down. Can you give me some bobby pins? Perfect. So after you wrap it around, then you're just gonna take bobby pins. So the trick with the bobby pins is this part, the wavy part, you face it down towards the scalp. That's the part that keeps it held.
I did not know that.
That's the trick. I never knew it either till I got into hair. So you're gonna take it and push it down, push it into the hair. And like I said, you always look in the mirror. Obviously right now it's sticking out too high. So you're gonna take your bobby pin and take a section. Go ahead and pass me another one. So
I think this one is like just like fun and like sassy, and it just, I don't know. Probably because I was a dancer, I like buns, and it's not like a, it's like kind of just like a.
And basically it brings the party to the party. In your hair.
In
right?
My hair, yeah.
It does. A girl that I went to school with, she would do this hairstyle on me, like a high pony half up thing, and she would call it the party pony. So that's where I got that.
Pretty funny.
Alright, so I'm going to use one more. I kind of based it off, like right now I feel like it's a little too high, so I'm just going to take it down a notch and go like this. Do one more going that way.
You can never have enough bobby pins.
Go ahead and hand me one more bobby pin. Perfect. Do you remember those little hair ties that people had that was like fake hair?
Yeah.
Thank God people don't use those anymore, that's all I gotta say.
You didn't bring some for the hair tutorial tonight?
Not today.
Next time.
Next time. That's a different vlog. What do you think?
I love it.
And then if you want to dress it up a little, you can add a bow around it too. If you want to be extra special, you can always think about it like this to dress it up. Kaley, turn your head back. And you can kind of push this around too. Perfect. So fun. Super cute. I love that bow on you.
It's super cute.
The bow's from H&M, by the way. If anyone wants it.
These are so fun. Love
it. Such a cute look for like a birthday or something, you know?
Yeah. Pretty. Or girls' night out.
That's right. Okay, so once we did that look, now we're gonna go to the party pony look.
Party pony.
Get ready for this one. It's very simple. Trying to keep everything on the simpler side so people can kind of understand how to do it at home themselves.
Yeah, because I'm very simple with hair.
Well, and sometimes people don't want to wash their hair every day, and they just want something fast and easy just to throw their hair up
and go on with their day and not spend an hour on their hair. So, fun part is getting this out. There we go. Awesome. Okay, so now we are gonna take our teasing comb, and you wanna use this side, and you just wanna take some hair. Now, Kaley, do you wear your hair half up, half down a lot, or do you usually just wear it down?
I normally just wear it down, but if I know how to do it more half up, half down, I like to, because I feel like it just gives a different look. I feel like I just always do the same thing all the time.
Those bows, with the scrunchie with the bows built in, they really dress up this look.
Mm-hmm.
So you can either just take it with the bow itself, or you can get like one of these, I call them the telephone cord rubber bands. I'm just gonna use this, and I'm gonna go like this. We're gonna wrap it around three times, and then we're gonna poof it out like that.
See, they make my hair so much more poofier.
Something, that's right. And then, and a tip for added volume, take the backside of this and push it out right here to give her a little more volume. Do you remember those buffets?
I actually just found some today. I was like, I can't believe I still have these.
Oh man. Where did you find that?
I have like this drawer of like hair stuff that I don't use, and that was in there.
Oh my
god. I think I had it from like dance team, like when I was in high school.
I just
college.
Love that, that's hilarious.
Should have brought them.
There goes that. Okay, so then after that, you're gonna take, I kind of back combed her hair a little bit, but I'm gonna smooth out the top part so it doesn't look too messy, but this is all for volume. Anytime you tease the hair, it makes it look a lot fuller and way more volumized, as you can see there. So, after that's done, now we're gonna dress it up with a bow. Let's use this leopard print one because.
So cute.
Yeah. I'm gonna do this one twice. Do you ever use the hair scarves?
I've tried like once, and then I made it look good once, and I can never do it again.
Super cute.
These are so much easier.
Oh yeah, these are easy because, again, we're looking for simplicity here, so in order to get that, just get the ones that have the bow built in. Yeah, there is that look. Kaley, go ahead and face towards this door so you can see the back. Perfect. So cute. It helps to have a cute model too. All right. So, there's that section.
Bam.
All right, so now we're gonna do a fun little easy updo for at home. So start with your hair curled, and then what we're gonna do is go ahead and you can tilt your head towards me just a tiny bit. I'm gonna leave out a section around her face about that big. Keep in mind you can always recurl that section later, but I'm gonna start out with hair that's about 3 inches going this way, and then we're just gonna twist it just like this. And as we're twisting, we're gonna grab hair from underneath, just like this. Add it to the outside hair, like this, and twist it around. Then add a little bit more. There we go. You want enough hair because at the end, I'm gonna end up pulling apart this little twisty. So you're gonna make sure you have enough in there so it'll look more full. So really, it's almost like the more tiny sections that you add to a twist, the better in the end. So you're gonna twist it all the way back like this. And then you're gonna take your handy little rubber bands, the mini elastic ones I showed you in the beginning. And you are just gonna wrap it around the very tail end of this little twisty. Perfect. Now I'm gonna go through and separate this little twisty guy. Then you are going to take a bobby pin and clip it right in the back, like so. Remember, the wavy side needs to go against the scalp, just like that.
I think that's like something I learned today.
That's awesome. You learned something new. So, and then obviously people have little baby hair, so those can fall out. So now we are going to take all this remainder hair, take a little more around her face, take this remainder hair and then just pull it all the way back, keeping in mind that we're leaving out a little around her face. So I'm going to take, I'm actually going to use the telephone cord one. Oh, it's on my wrist. Where'd it go? But yeah, I'm gonna take the telephone cord and put it around.
It's kind of like a low pony.
Yep, it's a low pony. That's the best way to put it. And then you're gonna take your teasing comb again, our teasing comb, and we're just gonna separate the hair like this, and you are gonna tease it like crazy. You wanna kinda go in a rounded motion, you don't wanna go back and forth because that's a good way to break your hair. So, do it like this. And then your hairspray. Keep in mind, for updos, hairspray is literally your BFF. Not even kidding. This is when we need our COVID mask on because, yeah, you can't breathe. My clients love this part now that COVID's been on because we have their masks.
Yeah, this is actually the first time I've seen you since like February without a mask.
That's amazing. Well,
because when we're at the salon,
we have to wear a mask. Yeah. That's right.
We're at home, so we don't have to.
I know, right? Okay, so then you're gonna take, after you tease this section right here, you can go ahead and take another section and go like this. This is a great style for when maybe it's day two and you're like, oh, I'm in a rush for work, don't have time to wash my hair, day three even. Just do this, put some dry shampoo on your roots, and you're good to go. So then I am going to take this part of her hair and just kind of wrap it around and twist it. Can you pass me a couple bobby pins? So actually, I'm gonna brush this part, Kaley. I'm gonna brush this a little more because sometimes when you tease it, gets super crazy looking. So you can kind of smooth it a little with one of these boar bristle brushes. Perfect. Now, take those little bobby pins. So I grabbed the hair like this and I just twisted it around going like this. So start from the outside, put the wavy part against the head. And I feel like this will be pretty easy for you to do at home on yourself. You just start with the low ponytail, twist it around, and then bobby pin it up. So, take another bobby pin like this. Perfect. Literally, you probably need a few, maybe four bobby pins to finish this look. But if you're going to like a dance party or something, you want enough bobby pins. Because
the more the better.
That's right. You want it to feel secure.
I remember from like dance competitions, we would literally be like pulling like bobby pins out like crazy.
I'm sure. So there's that fun little updo. I actually did one more. Sometimes you get flyaways like underneath where the bun is kind of. So you just want to take it and kind of go like this and get that extra hair like that. So I'm gonna take the teasing comb and kind of push it out. How does it feel, Kaley? Does it feel very secure?
I mean, it feels super secure.
That's what you want. So, before this look is done, we're gonna take our Karena iron again and touch up these little face frame pieces. And just give them a little bit of curl. I'm gonna come around on the other side. And these fall out so fast on their own, so you really don't need to brush them out, the ones around the face. Perfect. I'm gonna get this one so little. And also another trick, do not turn your curling iron up too high because you don't want to burn your hair and like make it feel dry or like fried or anything. So now you want to spray it really good with the hairspray. A cool trick that I learned is you can take your can of hairspray, and after spraying it really good, instead of using your fingers and messing up the style, spray it, take the bottle, and smooth out the flyaways just like this. The more you know.
So crazy.
And that little piece,
I know.
You have to make it look
make a little bit.
Shirley Temple.
Yeah.
Ta-da! So there's that look. And if you want, you can always dress it up with another cute bow. You can always incorporate a cute little bow in your little bun. Perfect. Another look that would look better with the bow is if you remove these bobby pins, you can take the, make a new bun. This one's gonna be a more messier bun look. Instead, that was more formal looking. You can kind of brush this out, take it again into like a low ponytail like this. Go like this. Pull it through. And then wrap this around. And then take the bow and put it in. And so something that you can do also with this, Kaley, you can kind of turn your head to the left just a little, is you can take some more bobby pins, and I'm gonna pin this bow with the hair down. So yeah, that's another look. Awesome. Pretty, pretty. The last look I want to show you is a fun little, very simple look with the scrunchy bow. I'm gonna take this little twisty tie out. This is a fun little ponytail. So I'm gonna actually take the twist out. You can leave it in if you would like, but I'm gonna go ahead and take it out. So we're gonna actually tease the top of her hair just a little, like this. Back comb, remember, go in circular motions. Comb it back just a little. Am I hearing you, Kaley?
No, I have a tough time.
There we go. Did you do cheer growing up?
I did dance. I did cheerleading for a year, but dance team, we... Oh,
that'll do it. Found another bobby pin. All right. This is where you want your cute little bristle brush, and you kind of want to comb the top so it smooths the teeth down a little bit. So, take the hair. And then we're gonna use our little scrunchy bow and go like this. This is a great fall up style. And then you're just gonna push it up like that. And then she has her cute little bow. Here we go. All done.
I feel like I'm like in grade school again.
Do you like that?
I do, it's so cute.
It's cute. I could have done it higher. Would you rather it be higher?
Sometimes I like them to be higher, but I think that's cute.
It's cute.
And are scrunchies in too?
Yeah, they are. Should we do a scrunchie one?
Yeah.
How about let's do a high scrunchie?
Okay.
Should I do a bun? How about a bun?
Okay. Try it.
Let's do it. Okay, so now we're gonna do a fun bun tutorial.
Promise Marcus, this is the last one.
We're sorry to bore you, Marcus.
It's gonna be in the know of all updos now.
That's right. So for this, you're gonna pull all the hair back. Keep in mind for buns, it's usually a more messy look, so don't make it too perfect looking. Take the hair, this. Sorry. And then kind of spread it out like that.
Cute.
So that is a fun little bun tutorial right there.
I love it.
Yeah, you can always make it bigger if you want, just like separate it. And then if you get too big, which can happen, you just take bobby pins and pin it down.
Yay! Oh my goodness. Thank you so much, Karena. This has been
so much fun.
I love it. Hopefully you guys have learned something, how to do a hair tutorial, and be sure to, you know, do it and tag her, and so we
That'd be awesome.
You can see it and I can see it. So anyways, thank you guys so much, and we will see you next Friday.
Bye. Yay.